Now, the ups and downs of the economy has lots of people looking for a financial planner, but how do you know what to look for? KNBC9's Bev Chapman is looking into that, and she's live now in the newsroom with more. Bev?
Kelly, we're going to take you behind the scenes here at Channel 9 to illustrate one suggestion. Or we were, because the door is locked. So I'm going to let you look inside here. One of the suggestions is to make sure that your financial planner has a neat office, because believe it or not, they say if they can't manage their own office space, it's a sad bet for them to manage your money.
With the rise and fall of the stock markets, a lot of people are worried about gambling their money.
We're advising our clients not to get out.
Robert Overton is a certified financial planner. We're not asking him for investment advice today. Today, we're asking questions for the person sending a child to college, trying to expand their business, or maybe someone who's hoping to spend more time on the golf course soon. How do you find a reputable financial planner?
If you ask your financial planner how they get paid, and they're even remotely hesitant to talk to you about that, that's someone that we would shy away from. How do you get paid is a very legitimate question.
Planners are either paid with a fee or a commission, depending on what they're doing for you. Picking someone who is independent is important.
No company is behind us pushing their product at them through us. If we're showing them something, it's because we think it's the best one that's out there.
If you're someone who's thinking about downsizing or worried about the job market, there are important questions planners need to be asking you as well. Whether you have debt other than your mortgage, credit card, student loans, whether you might need to care for your parents one day or are receiving an inheritance. And of course, they need to ask you the obvious, what kind of investments you have, 401k and IRAs, and how much risk you're willing to take before retirement.
Am I going to outlive my money, or will my money outlive me? And obviously you want the second one.
Back live. Now, we decided that if the door is locked, that's also a bad sign that that's not the financial planner you want. Now, we've barely scratched the surface of some of the things that you need to know. You can find out more about the certification a financial planner should have and SEC recommendations about how to make sure that you're getting your money's worth. Back to you.
Now, Bev, financial planners can do a lot more than advise you about your money, right?
They absolutely will. They'll take a look at your insurance, about whether you should start drawing down on your Social Security, even about tax implications. They can make recommendations that'll really put money in the bank that have nothing to do with your 401k or IRA investments.